Hey guys, welcome back to another video of Creatnprocess. Today we'll be working on a slides graphic design. During this design process, we'll understand the easiest way to create vectors, use 3D perspective view to create dynamic design, and also achieve a customizable project file. So to design this, we'll follow some interesting steps. First, we'll create out the vector bundle. So I have got some images from Google. We'll use these images to convert into vector and also trace out some images using the pan tool. So select the image, embed it, then trace the image to black and white. Then expand it. This will convert the JPEG image to vector. Now ungroup it and delete the white background. Now each element is separate. You can do the refinement by using simplify option. To do that, select the vector, then go to object path simplify. In this panel, keep the curve precision value around 97% and do the adjustments with angle threshold. Control the number of vertices to get smooth edges and then click OK. Also, you can do manual refinement by using direct selection tool, look up to all the vectors and do the adjustments. In the same way, convert the other images to vector and do the refinement. Use pan tool to delete extra points and direct selection tool to set the flow using handles. Here, refinement is the crucial part since these elements are going to be used in our main design. Other way to create a vector is by tracing out the image using pan tool. In this case, we'll trace out three knives, fill up the handles with flat color and the front part outlined, then using the line tool, draw the line of stroke white color, then duplicate one more on the other side. Now select both the lines and using the blend tool, click on one line then the other. This will create our steps. We'll give 7 steps in blend option panel and then click OK. After this, using the anchor point tool, make the lines curve by clicking and dragging the points. Do this for all the other sides as well. Do the adjustments until you get the nice pattern. Then duplicate the pattern and place it over the handles. With the Alt press, just click and drag to duplicate. Next, select the pattern and expand it. Go to Object Path Outline Stroke. This will convert the lines into fill object. Now, we'll subtract the pattern from the knife handle. And to do that, select both pattern and the knife handle. Then using the minus front option from the Pathfinder, subtract it. In this way, do the same for the other knives. After this, we'll do the arrangement of all the vectors and place them in an order. Then selecting everything, give it a flat color. We'll add little details to the knife. Using the pen tool, draw out a curve showing the sharpness. We'll give stroke thickness around 0.75 points. Finally, our vector bundle is ready. You can download this vector bundle from the link in the description. Our next step is to create the cover of our design. And to create that, open a new document and add a background shape using the rectangle tool. Give it an orange color and fade it a little in color picker panel. Then drag in all the vectors and place it aside. Now let's do a perfect placement of each element. We'll bring in the first knife and place it. Then for the second knife, flip it vertically using the reflect tool. Then place the other vectors maintaining a nice pattern. Each vector has to be positioned to get a balanced design. We have to do the adjustments with the sizes and rotation to achieve a clean pattern. Do this for all the vectors. Make sure that you are not putting lots of unwanted vectors. Place it where it is necessary. Keep it clean and simple. Once you complete placing all the vectors, group it up. Now, with the shift press, just rotate the group to 45 degree angle. Scale it up and place it diagonally to the overall rectangle. We'll add some extra vectors to fill up the empty areas. And to do that, you can duplicate the previous vectors and use it. With the Alt press, just click and drag to create the duplicate. After that, do the size adjustments and place it. Then, mask out the extra area by creating a rectangle of same size of the background. Then, selecting both the vector group and the rectangle, make clipping mask. Next, add the text, type out slice. Then, choose a proper font. After that, draw out a rectangle. Rotate it 45 degree angle and place it over the text. Increase the length from one side and now select both rectangle and the text and make clipping mask. This will give you a slice effect. Then change the font to impact and finally our cover is ready. We will continue the further steps in the next part of this video. Until now we have understood how to create vector bundles from images and use it to create a cover design. In the second part, we'll understand how to use 3D perspective option to create dynamic design and create a project file that is totally customizable. I hope you enjoyed the tutorial and check out the next tutorial coming up. And if you want more updates on designing, don't forget to like, share and subscribe.